All right, welcome back. We're gonna in this video today we're gonna take a look on how to make some propeller blades quick and dirty. I got a quick little technique that you can use. I'm currently working on this engine and propellers at the moment for a plane I'm working on. Pretty complicated engine there, but very cool to look at. So I'll have a time lapse eventually of that. But today I'm gonna show you how I went about making the blades. So let's go ahead and hide our old ones here and change our material. Let me get up these blade curves I've already got set up here. All right. So as you can see, I've got the perimeter of the rotation of the blades, as well as a profile that we can work with. So let's go ahead and select our profile here. I'm going to go ahead, period, and isolate him, because we just need him for now. I have seen several ways that people have gone about this, that just kind of add a curvature to it, but then they also forget to add a twist to it too. So that's what we're going to work on today. So a quick and easy way to do it. So I'm going to do Shift A. I'm going to select the center of that. I'm going to go way above here. Okay, so now it's lined up perfectly down the center of the profile. Tap G. We're going to come down just a hair. All right. So now we need to create our bit of a curvature to the blade, and then we'll add a twist to it. So Shift A. I'm just going to use these points here to help me out. I'm going to scale him. Want him to be a little extra large there, so when we do the twist, it won't cut through it here. So let's go ahead with that. We'll do Shift D. It'll put a, no, not Shift D. We want Shift S. And then G. We've subdivided the lines, so now it's a curve. We're going to put a bit of a curvature into it. Perfect. So now let's select our line, G, V to change the center point, and then grab your white circle, hold control, go to the bottom of your line that you worked on there, and what we need to do is hit F. And we're going to do curve array. You can search for it. I got it here, right here in my favorites. Select our center line. Now let's add a twist to it. However many degrees you want to go, I'm just going to go 25. The reason they put these twists into the blades is for, I basically, from what I've read, is it, so this way there's enough lift going across the whole blade, and that's why they put a twist in it. So if it's straight and flat, you're not getting lift all the way across the blade, or an equal amount. So that's basically the gist of it. So we're going to reduce our spans here, and then right-click to execute. While it's still selected, hit L, and that will create our twist. All right, perfect. Let's look down the center here. All right, perfect. Now we can go ahead and do a cut. Use our profile to cut there. Get rid of the excess there. Cool. We can get rid of all our extra curves here. And we'll come out of solo here. I'm going to take that new profile there, as well as this little base here, and we're going to go ahead and just do Control G and blades. All right, cool. Now I can turn off the old curves. All right, we're done with that. So now let's start making this a little more three-dimensional. So go ahead and select your face, and you can come down to here, thicken sheet, or I've got a hotkey for it for thicken, and then we just pull it out, and if you hit tab, it'll go in both directions. Perfect. And we're making it the final width to one side, because when you're talking about a blade, one side is narrower than the other side. So basically you're making a bit of an airfoil or a wing, basically, is really what it is. So a quick and easy way to do that, it's not 100% accurate. Like I said, this is a quick and dirty way. We're going to rotate V. We're going to find our midpoint here. There we go. Now, we just take this and then drag it over till it's like that. Perfect. We can get rid of that original profile there. All right. So now that we've done that, let's go ahead, isolate. I'm going to use Alt. Now select all the smooth edges on that. We're going to go ahead and delete them. And what we're going to do is create a round over to each side here. So I'll go ahead, select these two edges here, and just do L. And then if you tab it, that'll give you a little better profile. Let me get a little closer so you can see that. There we go. And you can see it's rounded over nice and neat. Perfect. Go ahead, select all these, join them together, because right now it's a sheet. It's not a full solid yet, but we're working on that. Now all we have to do is just do L. Done. And it puts a G1 curvature on there. And then L. Done. Done. We're almost there. Go to the bottom here. Fix this. Hold down Alt. I'll select that opening. And then you just patch hole. I got a hotkey for that one too. And Alt. Patch. There we go. Now it's back to a solid. Unselect it. Come back out. So now, kind of a dirty way to combine this prop to the engine and all that. I just made this little cylinder here. I'm going to delete the top of that. I'm going to patch it, but hit tab. There we go. So now, if you don't like just that perfect sphere, you can do a scale. Let's turn on our x-ray here. V, find the center of it. Now you can adjust that shape as you like. It only goes so far before it... Okay, looks good. Turn off x-ray. Turn off. There we go. So now we select this and this. Look at the side here. Okay, it's about center. Good. So now we could just do Q, Q. Merge them together. And we'll select that connect and edge there. Do a quick fillet, do a chordal fillet so it's even all the way around. It looks pretty good. And if we want, with this, we can rotate him just a little bit, give him more angle of attack here. V, find the center, there it is. And do 30 degrees. There we go. Turn that off. Take a quick look here. There's our blade. Perfect. Let's go ahead and do a quick array. There we go. It's already set to 3. Boom. And there you go. Here's your quick and dirty props. You can do a lot more to it there, but it has a pretty good look to it there. Let's go ahead and turn our fancy material on here. Take a quick look at what we did. That's it in a nutshell, guys. A quick and dirty way to do a propeller blade. You guys have a good day.